Hi, I am MD Nutritional Consultant. Today I have a very informative topic for my viewers, that is food safety. So let's go to check complete information about food safety. Food safety is used as a scientific discipline describing handling, preparation, and storage of food in ways that prevent foodborne illness. The occurrence of two or more cases of a similar illness is resulting from the ingestion of a common food is known as a foodborne disease outbreak. 1. This includes a number of routines that should be followed to avoid potential health hazards. In this way, food safety often overlaps with food defense to prevent harm to consumers. The tracks within this line of thought are safety between the industry and the market and then between the market and the consumer. In considering industry-to-market practices, food safety considerations include the origins of food including the practices relating to food labeling, food hygiene, food additives, and pesticide residues, as well as policies on biotechnology and food and guidelines for the management of governmental import and export inspection and certification systems for foods. In considering market-to-consumer practices, the usual thought is that food ought to be safe in the market and the concern is safe delivery and preparation of the food for the consumer. Food can transmit pathogens which can result in the illness or death of the person or other animals. The main mediums are bacteria, viruses, mold and fungus, which is Latin for mushroom. It can also serve as a growth and reproductive medium for pathogens. In developed countries, there are intricate standards for food preparation, whereas in lesser developed countries there are fewer standards and less enforcement of those standards. Another main issue is simply the availability of adequate safe water, which is usually a critical item in the spreading of diseases. 2. In theory, food poisoning is 100% preventable. However, this cannot be achieved due to the number of persons involved in the supply chain, as well as the fact that pathogens can be introduced into foods no matter how many precautions are taken. The 5 key principles of food hygiene, according to WHO. 1. Prevent contaminating food with pathogens spreading from people, pets, and pests. 2. Separate raw and cooked foods to prevent contaminating the cooked foods. 3. Cook foods for the appropriate length of time and at the appropriate temperature to kill pathogens. 4. Store food at the proper temperature. 5. Use safe water and safe raw materials. Physical contamination. Physical contaminants, or foreign bodies, are objects such as hair, plant stalks, or pieces of plastic and metal. 5. When the foreign object comes into the food, it is a physical contaminant. If the foreign objects are bacteria, both a physical and biological contamination will occur. Common sources to create physical contaminations are hair, glass or metal, pests, jewelry, dirt, and fingernails. Chemical contamination. Chemical contamination happens when food is contaminated with a natural or artificial chemical substance. Common sources of chemical contamination can include pesticides, herbicides, veterinary drugs, contamination from environmental sources, water, air, or soil pollution, cross-contamination during food processing, migration from food packaging materials, presence of natural toxins, or use of unapproved food additives and adulterants. Biological contamination. Biological contamination refers to food that has been contaminated by substances produced by living creatures, such as humans, rodents, pests, or microorganisms. This includes bacterial contamination, viral contamination, or parasite contamination that is transferred through saliva, pest droppings, blood, or fecal matter. Bacterial contamination is the most common cause of food poisoning worldwide. If an environment is high in starch or protein, water, oxygen, has a neutral pH level, and maintains a temperature between 5 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius danger zone, for even a brief period of time, -0 to 20 minutes, bacteria are likely to survive. Safe food handling procedures, from market to consumer. Proper storage, sanitary tools and workspaces, heating and cooling properly, and to adequate temperatures, and avoiding contact with other uncooked foods can greatly reduce the chances of contamination. Tightly sealed water and air-proof containers are good measures to limit the chances of both physical and biological contamination during storage. Using clean, sanitary surfaces and tools, free of debris, chemicals, standing liquids, and other food types, different than the kind currently being prepared, i.e. mixing vegetables/meats or beef/poultry, can help reduce the chance of all forms of contamination. However, even if all precautions have been taken and the food has been safely prepared and stored, bacteria can still form over time during storage. Food should be consumed within 1 to 7 days while it has been stored in a cold environment, or 1 to 12 months if it was in a frozen environment, if it was frozen immediately after preparation. The length of time before food becomes unsafe to eat depends on the type of food it is, the surrounding environment, and the method with which it is kept out of the danger zone. Always refrigerate perishable food within 2 hours, 1 hour when the temperature is above 90 degrees Fahrenheit, 32.2 degrees Celsius. Check the temperature of your refrigerator and freezer with an appliance thermometer. The refrigerator should be at 40 degrees Fahrenheit, 4.4 degrees Celsius, or below, and the freezer at 0 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 17.7 degrees Celsius, or below. 15. For example, liquid foods like soup kept in a hot slow cooker, 65 degrees Celsius, may last only a few hours before contamination, but fresh meats like beef and lamb that are promptly frozen, minus 2 degrees Celsius, can last up to a year. The geographical location can also be a factor if it is in close proximity to wildlife. Animals like rodents and insects can infiltrate a container or prep area if left unattended. Any food that has been stored while in an exposed environment should be carefully inspected before consuming, especially if it was at risk of being in contact with animals. Consider all forms of contamination when deciding if a food is safe or unsafe, as some forms or contamination will not leave any apparent signs. Bacteria may not be visible to the naked eye, debris, physical contamination, may be underneath the surface of a food, and chemicals may be clear or tasteless. The contaminated food may not change in smell, texture, appearance, or taste, and could still be contaminated. Any foods deemed contaminated should be disposed of immediately, and any surrounding food should be checked for additional contamination. ISO 22000 is a standard developed by the International Organization for Standardization dealing with food safety. This is a general derivative of ISO 9000. ISO 22000 standard. The ISO 22000 international standard specifies the requirements for a food safety management system that involves interactive communication, system management, prerequisite programs, HACCP principles. ISO 22000 was first published in 2005. It is the culmination of all previous attempts from many sources and areas of food safety concern to provide an end product that is safe as possible from pathogens and other contaminants. Every 5 year, standards are reviewed to determine whether a revision is necessary, to ensure that the standards remain as relevant and useful to businesses as possible. Thanks for watching my food safety video. I hope this video may give you huge information about food safety. Kindly hit the subscribe button for upcoming video. Bye bye.